By the 18th century, Europeans knew a lot about people in other parts of the world. The strong commercial connections with the Atlantic world were by this time hundreds of years old. Europeans had traveled throughout North and South America. And by the 18th century, too, news was coming back of Cook's voyages to the Pacific. There was a tremendous amount of information in circulation about peoples in other parts of the world. And for Enlightenment thinkers, this spawned a series of reflections, which can be summarized, I suppose, in terms of three general areas of kind of critical reflection. It led Enlightenment thinkers, first of all, to ask some questions about human nature itself. Did all of these peoples that they observed in the Americas, in Africa, in Asia, in the Pacific, did all these peoples share some kind of universal human qualities? Or were they different in some fundamental way? Within the Enlightenment, there was a strong presumption of universality, that there was something that humans shared. But this led them to ask, well, why were they so different then? And this prompted some questions about the history of these cultures. Did they change? Were they fixed? Were they stagnant? Were they stuck in some at some stage in development? And what many Enlightenment thinkers decided was that, in general, there was one path to civilization, and Europeans had somehow, by force of circumstance, climate was often brought up in this connection, had managed to achieve a more advanced stage, whereas people in other parts of the world had become stuck or had not completely developed and were therefore seen as primitive at an earlier stage of a single path to development. Now, of course, once people began to think about civilization in these terms and to try and understand human diversity in terms of this civilizational process, they began to ask some questions about whether or not it was a good thing. Was civilization itself progress, or had something been lost in the long journey from a kind of primitive state? And here, Enlightenment thinkers really differed. Many people endorsed and believed in a notion of progress and believed that the human spirit of rationality guaranteed, in some sense, improvements in material well-being, improvements in culture, improvements in knowledge. Others weren't so sure, and most famously, Rousseau, Jean-Jacques Rousseau, questioned the notion of progress at the heart of civilization, and in a very kind of subtle critique suggested that civilization forced people, in this he was very interested in the way that the need to live in society with others forced people to develop habits of self-presentation which were inauthentic. And here his critique was really of the court, where he believed that the rules of civility and etiquette that governed the way that aristocrats in Europe dealt with one another forced them to lie about their true feelings, to be deceitful about what they really felt in order to observe these niceties. And most famously, he emphasized that true virtue could be found with those who were the least civilized. And the sort of cliche that emerged from this was the idea of the noble savage. The North American Indian was most often cited, an object of fascination, somebody who, because of their closeness to nature, was more authentic and less tainted by civilization. So in conclusion, let's just summarize these points. The confrontation with other peoples in other parts of the world prompted a series of reflections, first of all, about human nature. Did humans in other parts of the world share some essential personality, aspirations, and characteristics? Second of all, it prompted certain reflections about human history. And here they assumed that there was a development in civilization in which Europeans had somehow arrived at a more advanced stage and people in other parts of the world were less developed, more primitive. And finally, the third reflection was whether or not this process of civilizational development was a good thing or a bad thing. And although many Enlightenment philosophers really believed in this notion of progress, others weren't so sure.